Keeping your food clean has always been important, but it's especially top of mind now with the virulent and deadly new strain of E. coli in Europe that has also sickened thousands. It appears that contaminated vegetables may be the source of the outbreak. While any produce can make you sick if improperly prepared, registered dietitian Catherine Hall says between 1995 and 2005, about 1,000 cases of sprout-borne illness were reported in Canada.
The Canadian Food Inspection Agency recommends that children, infants, the elderly, and immune-compromised don't consume mung bean sprouts, which are the white bean sprouts that we use in salads and Asian cooking, and alfalfa sprouts because they have a high contamination rate of E. coli and salmonella.
Hall says it's important to buy really fresh sprouts in enclosed containers or bags, wash them well under cold running water, store them in the fridge, and cook them to a minimum of 71 degrees. Remember the rule for cooking, if it's 71, it's done. Caitlin Maniatis, registered dietitian in Sunnybrook's oncology program, says generally there are four things to keep in mind.
That's the clean, cook, chill, and separate. So those are the four things that you want to remember when we're dealing with safe food handling.
When cleaning, wash all produce under cool water until it runs clear.
So with something like a cucumber, even if you're peeling it, make sure you're washing the outside. A cantaloupe or something that has a harder rind on the outside, use that produce brush to really help get in those nooks and crannies. And with lettuce, what you can do is you really want to remove each leaf and wash it separately.
Use warm soapy water for utensils, separate cutting boards for different foods, and wash your hands often. If you haven't already, make sure to invest in an instant read thermometer. It could be a lifesaver. You'll never know just by looking at food if it's adequately cooked. Maniatis recommends keeping your fridge at 4 degrees Celsius and your freezer at minus 18. And if you're going to thaw foods, do so in the fridge and on the lowest shelf so they don't drip and contaminate other foods. These may seem like simple and obvious tips, but consider this. There are 11 to 13 million cases of foodborne illness in Canada every year, a number that can be slashed by 85% with safe food handling practices alone. With Sunnyview, I'm Monica Mattis.